Before we begin to master how to draw a chemical structure, it's first important to know certain things about it. One of them being the use of dipole arrows. And dipole arrows are connected to an idea such as electronegativity. Now, we already know what electron affinity is. Electron affinity is the liking of an element towards accepting electrons. Remember that nonmetals like to gain electrons, so they have high electron affinity numbers. Nonmetals, on the other hand, like to lose electrons. Therefore, their electron affinities are lower. Electron affinity is similar to electronegativity. It's just the liking an element has towards electrons. Now we're gonna say, connected to electronegativity is the idea of polarity. And we're gonna say polarity arises when two elements are connected to each other and there's a major difference in their electronegative numbers. Here I provide you guys with a chart of all the electronegative numbers of a majority of the elements in the periodic table. Now, of course, you don't have to memorize every single one, but there are some that you should become familiar with. For example, hydrogen here is 2.2. Now, depending on which edition of your book you're using, some of you may see 2.1 also. Just realize that 2.1, 2.2, they're very similar, like they're only off by 0.1. So if you go with either number, it's okay. Then we're gonna say the other elements that you should become familiar with in terms of their electronegative numbers are carbon to fluorine, and then fluorine down to iodine. These are the ones that you should become familiar with. And I know it's a lot to memorize, but just realize from carbon to fluorine, they're only off by 0.5 from each other. Fluorine is the most electronegative number on our periodic table. It's 4.0. And everything to the left of it would be 0.5 less. So oxygen, take off 0.5, you get 3.5. Nitrogen, take off another 0.5, you get 3.0. Carbon, take off another 0.5, you get 2.5. That's basically half of the numbers that you should memorize. And then the other ones, just look for common trends from going from fluorine to chlorine to bromine to iodine. Now, based on what we've seen here on this chart, we notice that the trend is electronegativity increases going from left to right of the periodic table, and it decreases going down a group. This makes sense because as we go from left to right, we become more like the nonmetals. Nonmetals want to be negative because they want to become like the noble gases. Therefore, they have high electronegative numbers. Metals, on the other hand, like to lose electrons. So they don't like electrons as much, so their electronegative numbers would be lower. And as we go down a group, we become more like the metals.